The political dynamics in Sri Lanka is changing thick and fast with the Rajapaksa brothers at the helm of affairs. It's been a witch hunt targeting political adversaries and rivals. That's the way many critics have labeled the developments over the last few days. And in yet another example of the same, former minister and now a sitting member of parliament from the opposition, United National Party, Patali Champika Ranawaka, has been arrested. He was arrested by the Colombo Crimes Division on the advice of the country's attorney. This is in a bike accident case dating back to 2016. The point to note here is that the case had been reopened only after Gotabaya Rajapaksa gained power. Since the case was reopened, Ranawaka has found himself in trouble. On December 13th, an overseas travel ban was placed on Ranawaka, and now he's been arrested. What makes it a political witch hunt, you may wonder? Firstly, the sitting member of parliament was arrested without a warrant. And secondly, the speaker of the parliament was not informed about Ranawaka's arrest. Those are procedures to be followed. Sri Lanka's law makes it mandatory for the authorities to inform the speaker before arresting a sitting member of parliament. Let's tell you more about the case, which dates back to 2016. The accident case had been registered in February 2016. On the 28th of February in that year, a vehicle assigned to Ranawaka's ministry had collided with a motorcycle. The incident had taken place in a suburb of Colombo, and two people were injured. Investigation in the case revealed the two injured men were riding a highly powered bike. Such bikes are apparently not allowed on the roads. The magistrate ordered the court to arrest the suspects without the court's approval. Ranawaka denied that he was driving the vehicle himself when the accident occurred. Another man claimed to be driving the car and was arrested. And 3 years later, two witnesses have come forward with their own version of the incident and of what happened. They claim that it was Ranawaka who was behind the wheels at the time of the accident. The arrest now seems to be a hasty decision and a politically motivated one at that. Just last month, Ranawaka had revealed several details regarding fraud and corruption during the Mahinda Rajapaksa government. And during the tenure of Mahinda Rajapaksa, he alleged that the Rajapaksa sold the land of the army headquarters to the Chinese. Ranawaka said the sale was made by getting around the required procedure. The Rajapaksa brothers have made it clear that they are going to rule with a heavy hand and there would surely be casualties. Ranawaka seems to be just one of them. And according to Wion sources, a former health minister could be next in line to face the heat under the Rajapaksa government. And joining us on the broadcast this minute is senior journalist from Colombo, Chandani Karinde. Thanks very much, Chandani, for speaking with us. What's your initial impression of what's happened, an arrest which has taken place without even the basic procedures being followed, without a warrant, without the Speaker of the Parliament being informed? Would you classify this as political witch hunt?
It does seem like that, because it's quite unexpected, because accident happened in 2016. But during the past few days, we could see the signs that this case was going to be raised up once again, because the travel ban imposed on him. And now, on the advice of the attorney general, they are facing under arrest. So it does seem political, because accident happened in 2016, so it seems to be politically motivated, the sudden arrest. But we'll have to watch and see what happens tomorrow, because it will be produced in court tomorrow and then we get more details of what exactly happened.
All right, Chandani, what are the specific charges in terms of the case and the details that have emerged at this point?
Well, we know that there are allegations against the minister that because he was a minister at the time the accident happened, he used his influence and there were allegations that he was driving the vehicle, but then they said he made change the evidence to make that it was his driver who was behind the wheel. And then there was an allegation that some of the CCTV footage of the accident was deleted at his behest by the police. So there have been various allegations leveled at that point. And of course, you know, it seems that the whole thing was hushed up because he was a minister. And they probably intervened with the victim who was, you know, partially paralyzed or suffering serious injuries at the moment.
Right.
So since the change of government, the whole thing has made, you know, come up again, and there's all kinds of new special investigations being done.
All right, Chandani, thanks very much indeed for helping us better understand the details that have emerged so far regarding that incident and the case, which dates back 3 years ago and has now been reopened. Thanks very much once again.